Can you believe it's November 2019? Well, before you know it, it'll be 2020. But when you look back on 2019, can you proudly say that you were a part of something phenomenal? Well, why not the America Recycles Day on November 15th? This annual event is hosted by Keep America Beautiful, and it is the only nationally recognized day to promote and celebrate recycling in the United States. It's time to suit up, superheroes. Your training begins now. I'm Erin Husbands, protector of the planet, and it is my mission to educate and raise awareness on recycling, conservation, and sustainability, all to help you become a superhero and save the world. This month, we'll focus on recycling and the use of the four R's. First up, always refuse single-use plastics. Work on reducing your waste, and always try to reuse or repurpose. And the last ditch effort is actually recycling. All year long, I've tried my best to give you tips on how to recycle right and help to change those old bad habits into world-saving actions. So here are a few tips to help you get started with your recycling in your home and workspace. First up, decide on the item or group of items that you want to start recycling. Don't try and do it all at once. You will get completely overwhelmed. Small steps lead to big changes. Next, designate a place in your home or workspace where you are going to collect your recyclables. I like to collect mine in a spare trash can, and once a week when I'm ready, I will drop them off at my recycling center, but unbagged. Recyclables should never be bagged. If you're collecting items like batteries, perhaps reuse a jar or a basket, and let that be their place to live until it's time to drop them off. If you're collecting paper towel rolls or toilet paper rolls, it makes sense to perhaps use a small bin in those areas where you most often use them and collect them there. If you're collecting paper, once again, try a spare trash can, but with paper, you can bag the paper and drop off to the recycling center. If you're collecting cardboard, first make sure that there is zero food waste contamination, like on pizza boxes. Pizza boxes should never be recycled and always be composted. Other types of cardboard boxes should always be broken down so that way it saves on space in the recycling centers, and you can go the extra mile with trying to remove any of the excess tape before you recycle. If you're collecting items like plastic shopping bags or plastic wrap or dry cleaner bags, you can put those in one of those plastic shopping bags to make it easy to drop off at their designated location. When it's time to start recycling, start with the easiest group. In my suggestion, that would be the best buddies of plastic bottles, aluminum cans, and glass bottles. But whichever item or group of items you're starting with, always make sure to check for the recycling logo. But there's a catch. Even if the item has the recycling logo, doesn't necessarily mean it is actually recyclable. If you see a number inside of the recycling logo, that denotes one of the 7 plastic codes. And all that means is that particular item was made with some kind of plastic. So always make sure you are recycling right. Remember that the recycling logo isn't actually copyrighted, so technically anybody can put that recycling logo anywhere they please. On November 15th or at the end of the month, whenever you're ready to handle your recycling, make sure you snap a picture and share with us. I would love to see how our superheroes are doing in their training to help save the world. I'm actually hosting a month-long challenge starting November 3rd through the 30th. Each week we will add in an item within our recycling efforts. We're going to first start with the best buddies of plastics, aluminum, and glass bottles. You can easily put that at your curbside for recycling pickup if you have it in your area, or bring them unbagged to your local recycling center. The next week, we're going to add in cardboard. Remember to break down that cardboard, take off any excess tape, and make sure if it has food waste contamination to compost those items rather than recycling. Again, you can put that at your curbside or bring to your local recycling center. Next up, we're going to focus on plastic bags, plastic wrap, and dry cleaner bags. These items should never be brought to the recycling center. They won't accept them because these items get caught in the machinery and cause a very expensive repair. Put those together in one of those plastic shopping bags and bring to any of your local grocery stores. The receptacle bins should be at the entrance of their stores. And in the last week, we'll be collecting batteries. Once again, try to reuse a jar or a basket. And these lithium or alkaline batteries can be dropped off at most locations, such as Best Buy, Home Depot, or Lowe's. But you can always check your local community calendar to see when your biannual household hazardous waste collection date and location will be held. At this particular event, you can drop off not just your batteries, but old electronics, cell phones, paint, aerosol cans, and more. Well, I hope you've been inspired and excited to start preparing for America Recycles Day or participate all month long. Our goal is to get you excited and inspired to participate in year-round recycling. I'm Erin Husbands, Protector of the Planet. Thanks for watching and check back for our weekly Food for Thought videos, eco tips, blogs, and more. Be sure to also check out the links from the information in today's video. Now, let's go save the world.